We just hit the 6 o'clock hour, and you are waking up to a weather-worn day. A winter storm warning went into effect for the Twin Cities about an hour ago. We are live on the ground. As you can see, snow falling across the metro. You can see our live traffic cameras in the western suburbs. The snow is really coming down on 169 and in Mobile 11, which is also in the western suburbs. Yikes.
Yeah, so glad you could join us here on Sunrise this morning. We'll help you through your morning commute if you have to leave, of course. Hopefully you'll be able to work from home because you don't want to get involved in that traffic mess that is sure to happen later on. Right now, though, there are no school closings or delays. That could change throughout the day. So you can head to care11.com/closings for the most up-to-date list.
All right, let's get out to Guy, though. He's been tracking the snow and how much we're going to get today.
Right, now the snow has picked up and already starting to stick on the pavement back here, too. So later this morning, the commute looks messy even through the afternoon. Snow literally just kicked off, 32 degrees, snow through the morning hours. And now that it's snowing, it won't let up. So it will snow continuously through the day, the heaviest late morning through the early afternoon hours before things taper later this evening and then pushes completely out of the area by tonight. So I'll let you know how much snow you'll find in your neighborhood and a plus, of course, that 7-day forecast. Jin, any slowdowns on the road yet?
Not yet. But I bet they're coming, Guy, because look at this. This is the Golden Valley Plymouth area, 169 near Highway 55. You can see, look at how heavy this is coming down. It's here. And as we've been hearing from Guy, it's not going to stop for quite a few hours throughout the day. Looking at the roads, everything still looking good. Major highways and interstates across the metro, no slowdowns yet. Of course, as the snow continues to pick up and move across the metro, we will continue to monitor that because I do think that will change here, Alicia, as the morning goes on.
For sure. All right, Jen. Of course, we have team coverage for your weather-worn day.
Eva is live and checking out the snow. Whereabouts are you right now, Eva?
We're out here in Golden Valley, and as you can see, the snow is coming down. MnDOT is issuing a few reminders they put out on Twitter just for when you hit the roads. First of all, if you can, as Guy was mentioning, you know, if you can work from home, maybe that's best in that case. But also, if you do head into the office, try to head out a little bit earlier in anticipation of some slower traffic. Of course, that brings us to the next point they want to impress upon everyone is just slow down. You never know how others will be driving in this traffic. That's something that you can't control, and certainly how the weather is going to affect the road conditions. Also, allow extra space between you and the car ahead of you, especially if it's a snow plow. MnDOT says they'll have plenty of plows out and ready to make sure the roads are clear and safe for everyone. And again, after the first big snow a couple weeks ago, I do know that there were so many accidents that rental cars actually were all taken up. I called around to several of them, and they were booked out for about a week. So that just speaks to how many accidents there were after the first big snow. So again, it's just important to be careful out there. Allow for that extra space and certainly hit the road a little sooner if you can. For now, we'll send it back to you.
Okay, Eva, those are good reminders, and we'll check in with you in about another half hour. Thank you.
This morning, the airlines are bracing for a travel mess from this weather. Right now at MSP Airport, there's a handful of flights either canceled or delays. Check your screen. More delays are expected as more snow begins to fall.
And make sure you have the Care 11 weather app on your phone. We'll send you severe weather alerts. Plus, you can set up custom forecasts and check live radar anytime. Just search Care 11 WX to download or scan the QR code on your screen. This morning, 200 people are going to be okay after being stranded on a breakaway piece of ice on Upper Red Lake.
Such a wild story. This happened around 11:30 yesterday morning. Arriving emergency crews found a huge chunk of ice that broke away from the shore. There's up to 30 yards of open water between anglers and land. Resorts JR's Corner Access was able to get a bridge from their shore as an evacuation point. Even so, Nicole Biaggi, Minnesota DNR's ice safety coordinator, says it's important to consider many factors before walking on ice.
The ice is never 100% safe, so even though we recommend that you wait until 4 inches of ice, that doesn't mean that the ice is safe, and you need to consider a lot of other factors that affect ice strength, especially right now, the wind and changing temperatures, the sunlight.
The DNR also recommends wearing a life jacket or buoyant jacket and bringing ice picks with you. JR's Corner Access says they'll be closed today.
Here's a closer look at recommendations from the DNR when it comes to ice thickness and winter activities. Stay off if the ice is less than 4 inches thick. 5 to 7 inches for a snowmobile, a foot for a car, and more than a foot for a truck. And make sure the ice is at least 20 inches thick if you're putting up your ice house. They double down on the fact that the ice is never 100% safe. New charges this morning in a Red Wing shooting involving sheriff's deputy.
Fernando Carbajal faces 3 assault charges. That includes assault on a peace officer. Court records show Carbajal crashed his SUV near Bay Point Drive and Levy Road in Red Wing last Tuesday, then walked away from the scene. A deputy made contact shortly after. A fight followed. Then the officer fired his weapon. Both men survived. The Minnesota BCA is investigating what exactly happened.
Developing right now, the man who opened fire inside a Bloomington Chinese restaurant is waking up in jail. This morning, we're also learning more about last week's deadly shooting at a restaurant in Bloomington.
I'm Sharon Yu. The Bloomington Police Department has charged one man in connection to a shooting that happened at a restaurant that killed one person and injured another. The police chief says he believes the 47-year-old suspect, Aaron Lee, had extensively planned for this alleged attack. According to court documents, Lee targeted the shooting victim because he believed that he was having a relationship with his former wife. Patrons tried to stop Lee from shooting but were unsuccessful. Lee later took off and was located in Oklahoma after his cell phone gave away his location.
The former police officer who shot and killed Philando Castile in 2016 wants to be a substitute teacher. Now the Minnesota Court of Appeals said a state board must reconsider after initially denying his application. Geronimo Yanez was turned away in 2020 based on, quote, immoral character or conduct. The court called that unconstitutionally vague and says the board needs to focus exclusively on his fitness to be a teacher, not a police officer. Yanez was charged with manslaughter in the Castile case, but acquitted by a jury.
The Minnesota Wild are holding a big fundraiser tonight at the X. Some of the money raised tonight will go to Children's Minnesota's new cutting-edge technology. They're also supporting other important missions of the Wild Foundation, which includes growing the game of hockey. Wild About Children has raised over $2.6 million for charity since 2003. Was all of your holiday shopping done?
Probably not. No.
Exactly. After Cyber Monday comes Giving Tuesday.
And if finances are a barrier, your time and skills can have an impact where you cash can't. Forbes just published a few ideas. Here's a look. The simplest way is to volunteer your time. There are a number of nonprofits and organizations needing manpower. You can also host a virtual fundraiser or share your favorite nonprofit's Giving Tuesday campaign on your social media accounts.
Yeah, find a few hours in the day to go donate. That'd be great. A lot of companies actually let you go and do that.
Yeah,
now Tegna does.
They do. So you can get a little time out of your workday. Yeah. Well, let's check back in on school closings this morning. Some trickling in as snow moves through. You can see the most up-to-date list at care11.com/closings. Right now, it looks like there's 3 on that list.
All right, let's give you a look at the roads this morning. Mobile 11 is tracking snow as it moves in. You can see the flakes coming down there. And the radar is sitting right on top of us now. Here in the metro. Let's get out to Guy in the backyard who's been tracking it all morning for us. Hey, Guy.
Hey, snow continues to come down and will only turn heavier through the later morning hours and early afternoon. So get ready for that. The morning drive will be impacted by this a little bit later this morning. So if you can get out the earlier, the better. That would be ideal. And if you can work from home, even better. So snow continues to come down. You can see impacting already visibility. Visibility will be an issue this morning, as well as the light snow and some slick spots, especially by about 8, 9 a.m. is when we'll really start to see things stick. I'm already starting to see things stick here in the Care 11 backyard on the pavement. So a slippery commute, that's on the way this morning and for the afternoon commute as well. So let's get right into radar. Here's where the snow is kind of coming down the heaviest. You can see coming in from the southwest, North Branch, Twin Cities, down to Northfield, Glencoe, all finding some moderate snow for now, moderate to light snow. and this will continue to cycle and push north and east throughout the morning hours. We already are finding some snow also for you folks in western Wisconsin, finding some snow as well. Baldwin, Hudson, all finding snow as things will continue to usher off to the northeast. So winter storm warnings will expire at 6. That's for the counties that you see highlighted in pink. Also, winter weather advisory for counties you see highlighted in purple. That will go a little bit later through 9 o'clock later tonight. Moderate to heavy snow also expected there and some slick spots. So you can see a good portion of the state, even western Wisconsin, all impacted by this. So for the next 12 hours, snow heaviest again by 9 through about 3 o'clock. And then we'll see things quickly slow down by 5 o'clock later this evening. Things slow down and completely out of here by about 8 o'clock tonight, turning mostly cloudy to partly cloudy skies by tomorrow morning. Temperatures in the low 20s and things, of course, wind chills probably feeling like the teens, even close to single digit wind chills for tomorrow. So 32 right now, snow has started, north wind right around 9 miles per hour, making it feel like 24. Here is your 3-day forecast, 4 to 6 inches expected today, Wednesday, Thursday, some cool air, but sunny and bright on Thursday.
All right, 610 now. Thank you, Guy. Checking back in on 169. This is near Cedar Lake Road. You can see those flurries, more than flurries just now, really coming down in that area of the West Metro. But as we move further east, I've been monitoring this on traffic cams, and at least the visible snow on the cameras kind of cuts off in between 169 and 100. 100 not looking anything like those flurries we saw along 169. But as Guy has been telling us, it's coming. It's moving east. So especially if you're in the East Metro right now and you have to head out, now is a good time, sooner rather than later, because right now, as you can see, no slowdowns. The interstate's looking good. That will change, of course, as this progresses throughout the morning. Chris and Alicia.
We'll check back in soon again with you, Jen. And here's a live look from Mobile 11 over in the western suburbs. You can see snow really coming down, so take it slow. We've been saying it all morning long, if you have anywhere to be. And don't go away in 3 minutes. Is the Black Friday and Cyber Monday hype really all worth it?
Hopefully, a lot of people spend a lot of money. At 6:18, we're looking at if waiting all year for deals actually saves you some cash.
Plus, your chance to go to the 2024 Paris Olympics is coming up fast. You can score tickets to the biggest show in the world this week. That's coming up at 6:46.
Then a flu season staple is nowhere to be found. At 6:48, Jen takes us on her hunt for children's Tylenol. Plus, what your kids can take if their store shelves are empty.